Hey there, I'm Benjamin from LoveStarter. In this video, I'll show you how you can send a user ID to Google Analytics with the help of Google Tag Manager. This allows to understand how people engage with your website, even if they use multiple devices. For example, if they come to your website on their laptop and then later on their mobile, then with the help of user ID, you can see this multiple device journey in Google Analytics. In order to see this in your reports, you will need a way to identify people with your own user ID. This isn't something that Google Analytics does automatically. So in this video, I'll show you one way that you can begin sending user ID to Google Analytics. I'll show you how you can do this with the help of your email marketing platform, like ConvertKit or MailChimp. Since we are talking about tracking individuals in this video, I do want to highlight that you'll need to be mindful of the GDPR if you do have website users located in the EU. I have included details in the description below this video. So now let's get started and take a look at how we can begin sending user ID to Google Analytics with the help of Google Tag Manager. I use ConvertKit to send emails to my amazing community, so I'm going to show you how you can configure ConvertKit and start using user ID in Google Analytics. And you can find a link to subscribe to my emails in the description below this video. Once we cover ConvertKit, I'll also show you a technique that you can use if you are using MailChimp. And you can also use a similar approach if you're using another email platform or even a CRM. Let's get started by heading to ConvertKit. Once you've logged into ConvertKit, you need to enable the option to add subscriber ID parameters in your email links. You'll find this option by navigating to Account and then Email. Enabling this option means that any links in your emails will include a query parameter with the subscriber ID that ConvertKit assigns to each email address. For example, your subscriber ID might be 654321. So any links in emails I send to you will include ?CK_subscriber_ID=654321. We'll now be able to see when someone has clicked a link through to the website. If you're using MailChimp, then you'll need to enable e-commerce link tracking. Let's head to MailChimp to see this. All you need to do is create a new campaign. Once you've named your campaign, you can scroll down to the bottom of the page and select Edit to change the campaign settings. Then you just need to enable the e-commerce link tracking option. This will add a query parameter similar to the one in ConvertKit, but this time the query parameter will be MC_EID. That's it. Now it's time to configure Google Analytics. So let's head to Google Analytics. We start by enabling user ID. To do this, we need to navigate to Admin and then User ID. In order to use the special cross-device reports, we're required to create a new dedicated user ID reporting view. This gives us a set of reports that only include metrics and dimensions for our users that have an associated ID. You'll want to take a moment to read through the requirements. I'm going to agree to the policy and create the new user ID view. Once we start sending user ID to Google Analytics, we'll begin to see data available in the reports. Let's take a quick look at the reports now. Since we've only just created the view, there won't be any data available. But if we select Audience, then Cross-Device, we can see where we'll find the special user ID reports. Now we need to configure Google Tag Manager to send the user ID to Google Analytics. Let's head to Google Tag Manager. We need to modify our existing Google Analytics tag. Let's select Variables, find the variable used for our Google Analytics tag. Then select More Settings, and then Fields to Set. Here you'll need to select User ID as the field name, and then click the Add icon for the value. We need to create our own URL variable to capture the subscriber ID query parameter. So let's click the plus sign on the top right corner. Name the variable, then select URL as the variable type. Now I select query as the user ID is being sent as a query parameter when people click the email links. We enter the details for the query parameter, So for ConvertKit, we'll enter CK underscore subscriber underscore ID. Or if you're using MailChimp, you'd enter MC underscore EID. And then we save the variable. Then save the Google Analytics settings variable. Next, we can preview the changes to our Google Tag Manager container. I've already tested this out, so I'm just going to select Submit and publish my container. Now, when someone clicks through from our emails, Google Tag Manager will capture the query parameter that contains their user ID and send this to Google Analytics. So that's how you can send user ID to Google Analytics with the help of Google Tag Manager. I've shown you how you can do this for ConvertKit and MailChimp, but remember you can use a similar approach if you're using another email platform. All you need to do is pass the ID for the individual as a query parameter to your website, and then you can capture the value of that query parameter using Google Tag Manager. Once you are sending user IDs to Google Analytics, you'll be able to make use of the user ID coverage and cross-device reports. These allow you to understand how people engage with your website. You might also want to consider making the user ID available as a custom dimension inside your reports. This allows you to perform more detailed analysis of how people with a user ID are engaging with your website. Are you sending user ID to Google Analytics? I'd love to know. And if you have any tips you'd like to add, then let me know in the comments below. Take a moment to subscribe to my channel to receive the latest tips, tutorials, and more. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.